set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He's out to the 30. Tackle at the 30-yard line. The Knights and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
So the draw to the halfback picks up 4. It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. And he throws it away. Setting up play action. Well protected. Now he's going to run with it. He's going to go for the home run. Brought down at about the 17-yard line. Perfect time for the play action pass.
Well, here the defense is looking for the run, and the play action put him in even a worse position. They just weren't ready for the pass there.
From the 17-yard line, first down. Carries the ball for a nice game.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Quick throw. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
It's first and goal. 2 yards to the end zone. And he's tackled around the 1 yard line. They're crowding the line. Zone for the touchdown. And so he found his receiver for the score.
And the closer you get to the end zone, the more difficult it becomes to throw the football because the field becomes much smaller to work with. But they did a very nice job there to come up with the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. It was a 7-play, 70-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Side. They'll bring him down right around the 24-yard line. 1 yard loss for the halfback.
That is a textbook tackle right there. He leveled his shoulders and just put his whole body weight behind that one. Great hit.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on their own 24. He's to the 40. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Go down, go down. Mike Ford, Mike Ford. 48-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. Church off the fake, zips it left. This one is incomplete. Middle to the running back.
This is smart, efficient play call. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
Third down. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38.
Crunch time, defense.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Fires out to his wideout. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. Well, a new quarterback, but we saw this kid getting reps both in practice and in the pregame walkthrough, so this isn't a big surprise. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Got some open field, and it pays off. Touchdown. Very impressive run by the halfback to find the end zone.
Good play call here by the offense coordinator. He realizes when you get down into the red zone and you have a halfback like this, just give him the ball and let him find his way into the end zone.
The extra point to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. It was an 8-play, 76-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
They line up to kick this one away. Football, loose ball. Scoops it up. Oh, man, he took him down hard. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 29. To him before he could get back to the line. He throws left, stays in bounds, and made a nice catch. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48. He gets to about the 31-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
It's the tailback, and they hit him in the backfield.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 32-yard line. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately.
Number 40,
We've played one. We get a tie game at 7-7. Set to resume action here in quarter number two. Deadlocked after the first 15 minutes. Green to the back, and he can't hold it.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Trying to take the lead by a field goal. It has the distance, and it sails right on him. No good. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He makes it to the 28-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 28-yard line, second down. Completely stopped immediately.
That'll bring up third and four.
Play action. He goes downtown. Almost intercepted.
Number 80, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 4-4.
Meade is waiting for the snap. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And he's taken down at the 34-yard line. Been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Slings it. And he's taken down at the 45-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45. At about the 39-yard line.
Give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
From the 41-yard line, it's second down. Quick toss. It's knocked away, incomplete.
This is just an example of a safety reading the eyes of the quarterback and being able to get a good jump on the football to knock that away from the receiver.
Throws to the back. Oh, he dropped it. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. He makes his way to about the 28. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. He's taken down around the 34-yard line. And that'll be a first down on the 6-yard pass.
Short throws like this are very effective because they tend to wear down the defense over the course of a game, especially when they get you a first down and keep the offense on the field.
And I think it was the quick throw by the quarterback that fouled up the defense on that one. There he goes. And the delayed handoff works for a big game.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
First and 10. Ball on the 50. He's got an opening. Nice run to the outside. He's tackled around the 47-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. And they make the stop at the 33. Play is number 8 on the drive. Fires out to his receiver. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
But they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
From the 21-yard line, it's first down. And he's immediately tackled. About a 10-yard gain that time on the completion on the slant. This is the 10th play of this drive. The offense calls a timeout. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
Nice play fake.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. Slings it out and it gets tipped. It's third and goal from the 3, and this is a very big play for both teams. Hit immediately. They get a 1-yard loss on that one.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
This to try to put his team up by a field goal. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's out to the 30. He's got the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 39.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. He heaves it deep. Incomplete. Almost picked off. A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. Our score here at Kyle Field.
The Blue Jays, 10.
The Knights, 7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. People say college football is evolving, it's completely an offensive game. Boy, not this one. This one has that old school, hard-nosed, tough feel to it.
Yeah, and it's good. It's kind of refreshing. And I know the younger guys, you like all the points all the time, but it's fun to watch these kind of games because you see two defenses flying around. It looks like there's 12 or 13 guys on that side of the football making big plays, making big hits, holding the offenses down. In a world where we have all the fast-paced, up-tempo, scoring points galore, it's good to see some defenses bow their necks and play some good, pretty good ball.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kurt.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. Brought down at the 30. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Run play and he'll lose yards.
This is picture-perfect defense by this corner. Great job of providing run support.
It's second and 11. Ball on the 29-yard line. The sub package in there defensively in this five-wide receiver set. Gets it out quickly. They'll bring him down at the 42. Away with 5 yards on the carry.
That brings him second and five.
From their own 47-yard line. Second down. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. The halfback goes forward for about 5 yards there, and that gets him the first.
Again, they go with the halfback here, and again, he picks up some positive yardage and a first down.
The 40. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Here's the halfback. And he's tackled at the 28. The 27-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Well, he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 18. Ingram gains about 4 yards there. Kicks away, and he just drilled it from long range. Church looks ready to kick this one off. He makes it to the 28-yard line. A I tell you what, you got to give these guys credit. They put up a great defensive effort in the first half. They carry it over in the second half. Doesn't look like they're going to give in.
Yeah, and this game isn't over yet. I think it's going to require them to continue to play with this kind of edge and attitude to be able to give themselves a chance to win the game, because we still have a ball game in our hands and still a whole quarter to go.
Runs in, and he stops short of the line of scrimmage. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on their own 26. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. Ingram fields it at the 35, heading for the corner. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Just about ready to call the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last possession. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. He was way out in front on that one.
Yeah, there was no chance for the tight end to catch up to that ball there.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 49. Throws in a hurry. Tackle made at the 15.
Man, that was an impressive-looking play. When you can slice apart a defense like that, it puts a seed of doubt in their minds.
Throw. Very good tackle in space.
That'll bring up second and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Goes left and tackled in a hurry. Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. He gets it up. That's a tough break there for the kicker.
The kicker just cannot hang his head after that miss. I know he should have made it, but they may need him a little bit later on, and he needs to be ready and confident when that happens.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Gives it left side. And he's level at the 23-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. That'll make it 7-7. From their own 23-yard line. Second down. There's a play fake. He's going to air it long. And he stays in bounds to make the catch. First down. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. Our score here at Kyle Field, the Blue Jays 13, the Knights 7. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four.
Mike four.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here.
I think it was a great play call. It was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Up the middle for a nice gain.
That makes it first and goal.
Taken down just outside the goal line. From the 1 yard line, it's second down. Throws to the fullback. They can't hook up. Incomplete.
That makes it third and goal.
That's a 2 yard loss.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
So the offense will stay on the field. It's fourth down from the 2. Dives forward.
I'm not sure the offense had much of a choice here. It was a pretty short conversion. The defense just made a good play.
A missed field goal was the result of the last drive. We'll have to see if they can come through with something this possession.
Anytime you have a shot at putting points on the board and you don't get it, you get a little frustrated. But this offense is very capable of scoring at any time.
That brings them second and 5.
It's second and 5 here. Ball on their own 7. It's a great tackle at the 8.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Meade awaits the snap. Well, these defensive coaches have got to be loving what they've seen from their guys today.
Well, you and I talked to both of these coordinators getting ready for this game, and they put together a game plan. They shared it with us, and we're seeing it out there on the field today. They still are going to determine the outcome of this game.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Nice catch on that one. He's taken down around the 20-yard line. From the 20-yard line, first down. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Play action. Caught out in the open. Nice play to set up first and goal.
first and goal.
They're at the three. Second down. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. And they make the stop at the one. They'll try to tack on the extra point, but will take the lead. And he tacks on the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. A little over a minute in the game. He's tackled right around the 44-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker.
And here's the line, here's the line.
Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close.
That makes it fourth and inches.
They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. Room around the corner. He's at the 30. The 10. He's in. Touchdown. And they take the lead. So the offense is going to go for two. Here's the call from the referee.
Delay of game. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
Under a minute left in the game. Here comes the pressure. Now he's going to run and watch out. And he's in for two. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And they can forget about returning this one. The Knights have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him or do they do something different?
I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
Pass right, running back's got it. He's tackled in the open field. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, gave a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 28. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
To the running back. Brought down around the 41-yard line. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. 4 yards on that play.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
Spikes the ball. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. For all of you watching, it's been a great game, and it has a chance to be even greater. Will the prayer be answered? It's time for the Hail Mary. Once and all, going deep. That tackle just sealed the deal. The Knights, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.